Hey everybody, I'm going to show you how to update your firmware to your CraftBot 3D printer. And to do that, you're going to find that in the Craftware. It's going to be bundled with CraftPrint and of course the Windows driver. So first you go to our website, craftunique.com, and then you're going to go to Craftware, click on that, and you're going to scroll down and you're going to look for the newest version, 1.07 beta. Now this is offered for Windows. We don't have an updated Mac version, but we're working on it. That'll come out in a while. We're working hard to do that. But here's the Windows version. You click on that. Of course, save file. We're going to save. We of course already have it on our computer, and we're just going to overwrite that. Now we need to wait a little bit. Alright, let's click on that. We'll press run. Okay, now we're going to go through the steps. Next, at this step you do need to agree to the terms, and then you're going to go to next, 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 next. Okay, and installation successful, we're finished. And at this point we can actually go down and open up either CraftPrint, which is our printer controller, or Craftware. I'm going to show you how to find CraftPrint within Craftware. So Craftware is now open, and you press Control P. You wait a little bit. CraftPrint comes up, and at this point, it's very important that your CraftBot 3D printer is hooked up to your computer via USB, which it is. As you can see, CraftBot on COM, and then it'll have a number there. So it's hooked up, and now you're going to go to this box, and you're going to select Update CraftBot Firmware. And the first step, it's going to be downloading. And the next step is the flashing the main board step. And at this point, it may actually stop or freeze up. And to fix this problem, you just go to your CraftBot 3D printer, you turn it off, you wait 3 seconds, and you turn it back on, and it'll continue and finish up the second step. And right now we're going through that. And the third step will just be flashing the LCD. And once that's complete, you'll be ready to use your new firmware. Just got a little wait. All right, everything's good to go now.